Hi everyone, risk appetite declines as the world snaps back to the COVID reality. The Eurodollar hits our 200-day moving average target and Cathie Wood steps up exposure in 3D printing systems. Here are some hot topics for you today. So the risk appetite remains less than ideal as governments roll out new restriction measures against the third wave of COVID contamination. Germany will be closed for Easter holidays, for example. Restaurants in Switzerland won't open before April, and delay in business reopening across the globe also means delay in economic recovery for at least another month, and economies struggle finding fuel to reach the end of what has become a long tunnel. So to make things worse, the headache regarding the AstraZeneca vaccine just continues gaining momentum as the latest results published in the US and showing how effective the vaccine is could be outdated. Ouch! And it's a group of experts who actually contacted the US government agencies regarding the issue, which was completely out of protocol. So of course, the news and the way it came out hints that there could actually be something wrong with the vaccine indeed. So AstraZeneca will publish up-to-date results within the next hours, or at least it should. Otherwise, I'm afraid investors will start losing patience and drop their AstraZeneca shares in an accelerated fashion. AstraZeneca is already heading towards March 2020 lows, and nothing other than good news can save the share price from falling below the 6,000 P mark. Pfizer, on the other hand, is working on a COVID pill apparently, which could be taken at the very first signs of contamination and can prevent the infection from becoming more serious. So that's very much interesting and could actually be a game changer, as says the company's chief scientific officer. We all cross fingers for that to work out well. But for now, we are stuck with vaccine shortages, outdated test results from AstraZeneca that shakes the global trust but won't prevent us from getting the other vaccines, as we simply have no choice, and the third wave knocking at the door. So in all this environment, oil remains under the pressure of a delayed recovery, obviously. US crude extends losses below the $60 per barrel, and the price supportive factors are either rare or temporary. So the plenty of oil supply and prospects of a delayed pickup in global oil demand should continue weighing on oil prices in the foreseeable future. So we were talking that the U-turn in oil prices somehow dashed hopes of seeing the price of a barrel near the $100 level last week. The chances are that we see a further downside correction in the oil markets and oil prices, and the next plausible target for the oil bears is $52 per barrel, where stands the 100-day moving average. And under these circumstances, of course, today's PMI figures for March will mean quite little. Soft figures will continue waiting on prospects of economic recovery, obviously, while strong figures will probably not remain as strong, as the economic activity will take another hit from the latest lockdown measures in many countries. So for both case scenarios, it's not going to be a brilliant market reaction. So where do investors go? Well, they can gently go back to their tech favorites, as also, the Federal Reserve Head Jerome Powell reiterated for the sixth time at his testimony before the House yesterday that the inflation won't explode and the rise in inflation won't last long if we get to see any such rise in inflation, of course. And in fact, no one wants to see inflation pointing at the tip of its nose, but everyone thinks it's worrying that it does not. So, in all cases, practice makes perfect. It appears that there is a correlation between the number of times Jerome Powell repeats that investors should not worry about an overheating in inflation and the decreasing investor anxiety regarding the issue. So the US 10-year yield is below 160% right now, but the US dollar remains quite strong. So the euro dollar hit our 200-day moving average target on the back of this strong greenback. But now that we are seeing it change in recovery prospects and some relaxation in the US yields, levels approaching the 118 mark could actually be interesting tactical longs for traders looking for short-term trading ideas. But the overall trend in the euro dollar remains negative, with the 50-day moving average now preparing to cross below the 100-day moving average, so that's somewhere near the 120.50, 120.55 area, hinting that we may see a death cross formation within a week or two. So placing a take profit a touch below the 120 level wouldn't be a bad idea for those looking to play a tactical long in the euro dollar. And as we are snapping back to the COVID reality, the technology stocks are, of course, in a good position to benefit from another leg higher, as such Nasdaq futures outperformed in Asia, hinting that investors could actually return to their tech darlings for at least another record push before the reflation themes come back to the headlines. And if we see another boost in appetite in Nasdaq stocks, why not diversify from big tech and try new and other promising industries? So Cathie Wood, the CEO of ARK Investment, for example, who has certainly become one of the most popular investment managers in the globe of the moment, and who actually loves Tesla and Bitcoin, well, she beefed up her 3D Systems holdings this week, benefiting from a near 10% dip in the stock price in March as a result of missed profit targets and the delay in 10K form filing from the company. But who cares, right? There is no doubt that the 3D printing technology can only get better and democratized, force the limits of traditional manufacturing processes and our imagination, and has already a strong demand from healthcare services. The healthcare leg delivered up to 48% revenue growth in a year only, and the door is obviously wide open for more areas, including biotech, organ printing, and you name it. So last month, 3D Systems introduced a high-speed fusion 3D printing system for aerospace and automotive market applications as well. So it's an interesting place, B. There is a huge potential. But now the 3D Systems revenues took a solid hit during the pandemic, especially from the industrial revenue side. But the latest quarter showed that there is improvement in that area, and we are now getting close to the levels we've seen before March 2020, and that's encouraging news. And there is no doubt that 3D printing will spread to many, many more industries. As I said, it opportunity is huge. But the share prices went skyrocketing late January this year due to a short squeeze as well. So the 3D's share price surged from $5 to $55 in a matter of days and held ground about the 20 mark. To me, the question is not whether it's an interesting buy, but it's when would it be an interesting buy. Apparently, the $20 zone seemed quite interesting for Cathie Wood to strengthen actually her long position by another 140,000 shares. Now, the average 12-month target price for DDD is around $27 per share, but I would expect the Cathie Wood investment would push this price target a little higher. For those who think that the 3D price is overvalued right now, there are other 3D printing companies out there who could be interesting picks, including Strategist, X1, Prolabs, and VoxelJet, which also saw their prices boosted, but not as much as 3D during the short squeeze we've seen in January. And oh, by the way, Cathie Wood holds the first three names, so Strategist, Exxon, and Protolabs in her portfolio as well. And a final word on GameStop earnings that were announced yesterday. The company missed earnings, revenue, and sales expectations, which doesn't come as a surprise to me, because the expectations were perhaps too ambitious, but the results were not too bad per se. So the GameStop's share price pushed shortly higher in the after trading hours, then dived 15% at the time I'm making the show. It will sure be interesting to watch where the price settles once the second price bubble is over. And on the back of these concrete results, I remind you that the analyst 12-month target price is no more than $33 per share, but the restructuring efforts of the company and the shift to online business and maybe become a tech company does provide a growth potential for GameStop that actually could set settle the price well above that $33 level. So it's just a matter of how strong investors continue believing in a Cohen-made miracle. This is all for today. I'm Ipek Ozkardeskaya and thank you for joining me. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and insightful to you. Please do not hesitate to follow us on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates and subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I'll meet you tomorrow and until then, good day trading.